In this video, we're going to talk about a topic which hasn't had much publicity in recent months, but it is getting ever closer to being finalised, which is the Clipboards API for web browsers. The Clipboards API allows you to interact with your computer's copy, cut and paste actions in a way which hasn't traditionally been possible with normal HTML. Now, you may think that this is a very basic functionality, but browser manufacturers have been keen to avoid including it within the browsers by default because of potential security concerns. The biggest concern is that by giving access to your clipboards to any website that you visit, potentially any website that you visit can and will manipulate your clipboard in malicious ways. The Clipboards API, however, only surfaces the very basic functionality. Now, this isn't to say that you cannot access the clipboards within a web page, just that you'd need to use plugins like Flash, for example, to actually access and manipulate the clipboard. And in recent years, the internet as a whole has decided that Flash has no place within a modern website because of the security concerns inherent within that language, which is why having access to the clipboard natively is such a good thing. So I've gone ahead and created a very basic page template to help us demonstrate what's going on within the API. At the moment, we just have a header, a text box with some text in, and a button which currently does nothing. And then a second text box, and then a button which resets the contents of this second text box. So if we add some D's into there, we can reset the content, just for ease of use. At the moment, of course, we can copy any words and paste them wherever we want. But a new event has been created, which triggers whenever someone copies anything from a website. At the time of creating this video, only the right-click copy works within other browsers, such as Internet Explorer. But the shortcut, Ctrl-C for example, works within Chrome, because the Chrome implementation is more for features at the moment, although this will change over time. So if we look at the code for this page, we can see that we just have some basic styles included here. The very basic reset function for our button, then our header, the first text area, the first button, the second text area, and the second button. On clicking the second button, we call this reset function, and at the moment we have this command to execute the copy event, although we don't actually have a copy event at the moment, but we can go ahead and add one in. So I've gone ahead and created a copy event as mentioned, and this event currently just replaces anything that's been copied with the text copies from your site.com. If we go back across our browser and refresh the page, anytime that we try and copy something now, so if we try and copy this projects, if we try and paste this, we're going to get copies from your site.com because this code here overwrites what's currently being copied by setting the data and then prevents the default action which would overwrite what we're copying. Now, you could of course customize this however you wanted, so you could allow the user to copy text and then just append this string onto the text which is being copied, for example. But for most web applications, getting data out of them isn't the issue, it's getting data into them which is. And I'll go ahead and add in the code for the paste event. So as you can see, the paste event is very similar in that we just add the new event listener to the document as we did with the copy event. But rather than allowing our user to paste into any field at all, we're going to actually control how the pasted content is actually going to be appearing on our page. So in this case, we're going to filter it so that wherever we paste our content, it's always going to appear in the paste area. So if we go back across to our browser and refresh again, we can copy the word stretch and try to paste it into this top box. But as you can see, it appears in the bottom box, despite the fact that this isn't where we've actually pasted it. And of course, it doesn't matter what it is that we're pasting, it's always going to appear in this bottom box. And because of the way that we've done it, we're always going to overwrite the contents rather than appending. So let's go ahead and uncomment this copy event as well so that we can interact with both at the same time. If we refresh the page, we can see that if we try and copy the project's word, we can then click paste and we're going to have copies from your site.com. And of course, you can get much more complex. We're simply pasting the text here, but you could of course be pasting a comma separated list. You could, of course, within this actual element itself, separate out all of the different elements within that comma separated list and apply them into different fields within your web page. So for example, if you just copy comment out this again. So I've added the word split here, with a space being our character that we're going to split with. And here I've added one as being the index that we're going to paste out. So if we save this and go back to our browser again, and refresh again, if we copy this text now, and paste, we're only going to get the first index, which is 0, 1, so text. Now you may notice something else within these two elements, which is that in each instance we have the actual type of text that we're copying, and we're specifying that we're going to be copying plain text, both in the paste element and in the copy element. And this is actually the functionality which allows you to build extremely interactive websites. So if you do some validation and determine that you're copying a file into a web page, you can build some functionality so that you can automatically upload a file whenever it's pasted into a web page, which makes web pages in themselves a lot more interactive and a lot closer in functionality to something like Windows Explorer. So a typical workflow with such a website could be copy the file from your local machine and paste it into the web browser, which handles the uploads and then redirection to that file on the web server. Although the code to actually achieve that is beyond the scope of this video. Now there's not much more to say within this video, the purpose of which was just simply to bring attention to people the fact that the Clipboard API does exist and it does work, at least in Chrome at the time of recording, and it is expected that this will be integrated within other web browsers in the near future, and also the fact that it is now possible to copy and paste reliably to and from a website, which does mean that you can, if you want to, take your application to the next level by adding some very simple functionality which then feeds into more complex functionality. Now the Clipboard API, as I say, is still currently technically in the development phase. But if this video has been useful, please leave a like and subscribe.